Good morning. Our guest speaker plays a pivotal role in fostering socio-economic progress in Mindanao by spearheading collaborative efforts among national agencies, LGUs, NGOs, and development partners. Additionally, she serves as the Philippine Signing Minister for the Brunei Darussalam Indonesia Malaysia Philippines East ASEAN Growth Area, or BIMAYAGA, economic cooperation, emphasizing her commitment to regional development. Prior to her appointment at MINDA, she showcased her leadership as a city councilor in Davao City, where she championed youth empowerment, women's livelihood programs, and peace initiatives. Recognized for her contributions, she received prestigious awards such as the TESDA Kabalikan Award and was named one of the 10 outstanding councilors of the Philippines. Her dedication to professional growth is evident through her participation in international programs like the SHAPE for Southeast Asian Youth Program and the U.S. State Department's International Visitor Leadership Program. With a background in communication and management, including a master's in management degree here from UP Mind, she brings a wealth of expertise to her role. We are honored to have her insights and experiences with us today, so please join me in welcoming our esteemed guest speaker, the Honorable Secretary Maria Belen S. Acosta.
Thank you, Ma'am. UP President Honorable Angelo Impimenes, UP Mindanao Chancellor Professor Lyre Annie Murao, palakpakan natin si Chance. Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs Professor Annabel Novero, thank you for the intro, Ma'am. Vice Chancellor for Administration Assistant Professor Leo Manuel Estanya. I also see from the audience our powerhouse alumni, to name a few, Sir Angie Angliongto, palakpakan po natin, Mr. John Gaisano, former Chancellor Larry Digal, siya po ang Chancellor nung ako ay nagturo sa local governance ng SOM. Of course, Mr. Kitoy Guevara and First Lady, only lady, Mr. Dan Gillian. I also see Professor Luz of SOM, dyan ako galing. Si Florence, dyan ako galing sa SOM. Executive Committee, the Management Committee, the Anniversary Committee, chaired by Professor Karen Joyce Cayamanda. Maraming salamat. Mga scholar ng bayan, and to all here present, assalamualaikum, kong mayong buntag sa tanan. Magandang umaga, UP Mindanao, and happy 29th founding anniversary. Let me first congratulate the organizing community for this successful event. It is good to be back. And what better time to visit the campus than during today's commemoration of its 29th year. It is an honor to be invited here both as an alumni, and ako po ay nagtapos ng Master's in Development Management dito, School of Management sa UP Min, at nagturo din ng local governance sa UP Min SOM. Diba, Sir Larry? And now as Secretary of the Mindanao Development Authority. I am also proud to share that many of the officials and staff of MINDA are from UP, continuing and living the UP values of service, honor, and excellence throughout their work for Mindanao. MINDA also celebrated its 14th anniversary just last week, and I am certain that for all of those 14 years, UP Mindanao has been MINDA's partner in its pursuit for a peaceful and progressive Mindanao. I know that several faculty and researchers of UP Mindanao have also been MINDA's active partners implementing key strategic programs such as the Mindanao or Nurturing Our Waters program, the Mindanao Development Corridors, and in the formulation of the Peace and Development Framework Plan for Mindanao. And most recently, for the updating of the document we now call the Mindanao Agenda. Due to this year's theme, Duyog sa Pag-alagad, Sustainable Partnership in the Service to the People, UP Mindanao has been one of the government's unwavering partners in fulfilling the Mindanao Promise. With a new UP president whose heart beats strongly for Mindanao, I can already see an even productive and at some point busier year for everyone here. Kasi sobrang passionate ng ating UP president. Parang he wanted everything 20 years ago, 30 years ago. But that is what partnerships are for. We do not have to do all the grand things alone. This is something I've learned in my few years as Minda secretary as well. In a way, we both share similar realities. UP MIM is among the younger campuses in the UP system, while Minda is also a relatively small and young agency. And yet, we did not let this stop us from achieving more for the sake of our organization, but more importantly, para sa bayan at para sa Mindanao. But key to us delivering and achieving more as our strategic partnerships. I recently met with UP President Jimenez, and I'm certain that this will be another productive year of pag-alagad sa Mindanao, with the UP MIM campus leading the way. Alam niyo po, ang UP Mindanao ay pangarap lang nung araw. Parati naman tayo nabubuli dito sa Mindanao, di ba? Parati tayong catch-up plan. Ilang taon na tayong catch-up plan. But in the end, we survived and we prevailed and we succeeded. Marami ngayon sa Mindanao ay highly urbanized cities, pero meron pa rin naiiwan ng mga fourth class, fifth class municipalities. So yes, meron tayong achievers at meron pa rin tayong mga catch-up plan for those who still need our help. Sabi nila, for every work of God that is blessed, lahat yan ay dumadaan sa crucible. First, it is impossible. Second, it is difficult. And third, it is done. So yes, it's done. 29 years na ang UP Mindanao. Palakpakan po natin. And marami pa tayong mga gusto na dati ay imposible, ang magkaroon ng hospital, ang magkaroon ng UP College of Medicine dito sa Mindanao. Lahat yan ay work in progress, pero gaya ng sinabi ko, ito ay mag-umpisa sa first stage na impossible, second stage na difficult, up to the time that it will be done. Every work that is blessed by God, ganyan talaga ang stages na pagdadaanan. Speaking of sustainable partnerships, I am happy to note that many of our existing and upcoming programs in MINDA can be complemented by what UP MIM has been doing. For instance, one of our programs under the Mindanao Agenda on Food, Energy, and Water is support to Mindanao food and agribusiness value chains, which we can collaborate with your existing agri-aqua value chain laboratory, developing upgrading strategies for our priority industry sectors. It is also reassuring to have the academe at the forefront of our peace and development efforts. This is why we are fully supportive of the upcoming UP Farm Institute, which is aligned with our ongoing partnership for peace and development in Mindanao with the European Union, a key result of Mindanao Development Forum. Minda is also currently facilitating the preparation for the upcoming hosting of the BIMPEAC Malaga Friendship Games in Mindanao. And I believe UP Mindanao has also been involved in this, and we are looking forward to finally staging the Friendship Games in Davao City with you as the academic partner. We have yet to tap UP Mindanao again for the annual Mindanao Policy Research Forum in partnership with the Philippine Institute for Development Studies. I hope we can do this in the next few years, if not this year. I would like to present all our programs and projects for the year where we can further partner or collaborate at a proper time. Ma'am Lair, you are very much welcome to visit us at Minda so that we can further collaborate kung ano yung mga program and have the convergence points. Because this is the golden opportunity for UP Min, Minda, for Mindanao, because there is relative peace in the land. Come 2025, yung Bangsamoro Transition Authority will have its regular elections. That will be next year. At yung mga dating maraming insurgency, ngayon ay mga insurgency-free areas na sa Mindanao. So this is the golden opportunity for all of us. And this is a golden opportunity for UP Mindanao, Minda, and all the other civic organizations to come together and really do its magic for Mindanao. Rest assured that Minda will continue to be your partner for service, honor, and excellence. Once again, happy 29th anniversary, UP Mindanao naming mahal.
Bigang salamat, Mindanao Development Authority Secretary Mabel Sunga Acosta. Palapakan po ulit natin.